In the words of the United Nations Secretary General, when he addressed us by video yesterday in the opening ceremony, we must harness the power of ICTs for economic and social empowerment for men and women. And here I stress men. Men are part of the solution, and I thank each and every man that came this morning to join us.
This is the time to get women to the tables where the decisions are being made to shape the world and to shape its future. And I'm simply pleased that here in ITU, we are doing so.
These breakfasts became a breakfast in 1994 at the Kyoto Plenipot. And I believe we had a huge number. We had 55 women there. The Thai delegation brought gifts, and it was the first time that we had to turn to the private sector and others to sponsor. And over the years, the 22 years since we started to do this, we have grown in number, we have grown in responsibility here at the ITU, we have grown to include friends of women who we call men, and we have grown to take more and more of an understanding within the ITU circles and our home circles of the importance that women play and can play in the ICT area.
Even if the number today are fewer for women to use the internet, if the possibility are given to them, they will use internet and they will use it the same way as all their brothers. And being a woman in the technology means that women are able to do every job as men. Means that women have the same possibility as their brothers.
From words to action, do you see gender appropriately reflected in the global political agenda for ICTs?
I think we're starting to see that, and a lot of it is due to the work of the ITU and how you have promoted gender in ICTs, Girls in ICT Days, Gemtech Awards, and all the things that you're doing. And because the ITU is a multilateral organization, you have the ear of 190-something countries. And because of that, we are getting more traction in women in ICTs in the political agenda.
Yes, I'm concerned. I think evidence suggests that women are already being left behind in the information revolution, and we must do everything in our power as a female leader to make sure this does not continue. I will not share the statistic that Doreen had shared with us.
We may first consider women as the first technologists, since they developed tools, they developed methods to gather food and plant crops and make clothes and heal illnesses. So women made everyone's lives easier, and their families, their communities, and subsequent generations. Ease and production are what technology provides for us today.
I think that last two years, I tried to convince everybody also the gender issue balance in every organization. And for me, it is very important to give the proof that this is possible also in ITU. ITU, a special agenda of UN, responsible for ICT in the whole world. This is very significant and very important issue for me personally, also for me as a woman.